Hello everyone, how are you? Hope you are doing well. Welcome to MA Consulting channel. If you are new here, please subscribe your channel with follow of bell icon to get the regular updates. Now let's get started. Today our topic of discussion is RBP, which is called role based permissions in SAP SuccessFactors. Now let's get started. Today our agenda is, what is role based permissions? How to turn on role-based permissions in provisioning and how to grant user access. To grant user access, we have three steps to follow: permission groups, permission roles, and grant roles to previously created granted groups. Now, first take a look, what is role-based permission? Role-based permission, RBP, basically nothing but the security model that controls the entire permission system. Here we provide different kinds of roles, permissions, and authorization to employees so that they can perform specific tasks. Now, I want to elaborate you what is role-based permission with the help of an example. Suppose an employee belongs to IT department. His responsibility is to install and maintain of a computer network system. So when he logins into the system and he have to maintain computer network system, how can he achieve this? So the system is allowing him to maintain and install computer network system because the maintenance and installation of computer network system role is assigned to his ID, so he is authorized to do that job. There are three elements in role-based permissions. By using these elements, entire role-based permission can be designed of a company. These include granted user, target user, and role are nothing but the bunch of permissions. Granted user are those people of groups to whom the permissions and authorities have been given, and targeted user groups are those to whom that permissions and roles authorizations are performed. Note, in role-based permission is approved for an organization with up to 1.5 millions of employees, and this bar will increase in future. Here I will elaborate you role with the help of an example. Suppose we have a role name HR role, and in this HR role we have three permissions: view performance rating information, edit potential rating information, create performance review form. Now we have to give this bunch of permission HR role to granted user in the name of USA HR. And when we grant this bunch of permission role to USA HR group, these HR USA group will perform specific tasks to targeted user USA employees. Here I want to elaborate one thing. The group, granted user group you have created for USA HR, will only perform specific task to only USA employees, not to German employees. Setup process. How this process will set up? First of all, we have to enable role-based permission in the provisioning. To set up role-based permission, first you need to enable role-based permission from the provisioning. After that, you have to save the setting. And then when the permission is set up, you have to create permission group. Now I will elaborate this permission group in this system. Here in the search bar action, you will search manage permission groups. Click on manage permission group screen. Manage permission group screen will appear. In manage permission group, you have to create new group. Click on create new, a pop-up will come here. Give the specific group name. Here I will give 100. And on people pool, you can see there are so many categories you can choose. For example, I will choose country. Here I will choose username as a category. I will choose Christian Dolan. And then click on finish. And when I click on the update, you will see one member is added in the group in the name of test 100, which is granted group. I will give it the name as granted test 100 test granted. Now finish it. Now the second group I have to create is for the targeted group. Click on create new once again. And here I will give the name 100 targeted group. And on people pool, I will choose this time as job location. And on location, I will here choose USA, Atlanta. And on that Atlanta, when I click on finish and click on update, okay, no impact, no worries. We will choose another one. Location. Okay, here I will choose as this location. Click on finish. When I update, 14 active member group people are present in this people pool category. So I have created another group in the name of targeted group. Now click on finish. Now first step is completed as we have created permission groups. Now the second step is to create manage permission role. Click here, manage permission roles. Click on this screen. Manage permission role list. Screen will appear. Click on create new. Whenever you have to create role, there are three things you have to get it considered. First is role name, and the second thing is permission setting, which permissions you want to give this role, and last is grant this role to already created granted group. First I will give here name 100 test role. And next thing is give it to some permissions. Okay, I will scroll down a little bit on employee data. Okay, payroll. I will give some payroll permissions to this role. Select all, finished. Now I have given this role some payroll permissions. Now the last thing is I have to grant this role to granted group. Click on add. When add, a pop-up will came. Now it's asking for permission group. Here click on select, and here I will find my granted group I have created, which is 100 granted group. Click on this group name, it will appear in here, and click on finish. Now one more important thing, if you want this granted group to perform task on everyone, then I will choose everyone. And if I don't want everybody in the company to be performed by these permissions, so I have to create group. So we have already created that group before. So to select that group, I will select on this, and here select option appear, and here I will give it the name 100 targeted group. Now my group is selected. Click on finish. I think it's not selected. Let me do it one more again. 100 targeted group, finish. Now one more important thing in role based permission, this checkbox, exclude grantee user from having permission to access themselves. If I don't want that in granted group, the same person will perform those permission to themselves, I have to ensure this thing by checking on this checkbox. So when I check on this, then click on finish. Everything is ready. You have seen that we have granted this role to this granted user group. So the last step is to save. When you click save, it will take some time to save. When the role is saved, it will again refresh the screen. So now we are good to go. Thank you.